lot of people get relief if they went to Shirdi or if they went to Lourdes. You know, a lot of people go to Lourdes. I'm talking of the West, with the water. A lot of them get a benefit. Do you know how it happens? Quantum healing. The minute you think you are cured, you just have to think seriously, believe in it. Not just say, I will think because BMX has asked me to think. No, no. You must believe in it that if I went to Shirdi, I will be cured. You must believe in it. And then what happens is the quantum healing starts. What is in quantum physics? Your body is not your body. Your body is energy. Energy is matter, matter is energy, which is called aduality in quantum physics. The man who found out, Hans-Peter Dürer, who was till recently my co-editor in our journal, fascinating old man. He was 89, so enthusiastic. He doesn't carry a cell phone because he believes nuclear energy is very bad. He's a nuclear scientist. And he goes all over the world, and his wife doesn't know where he is. So she'll occasionally call me, do you know where Peter? I have lost him. 2 months he is not there. He said he's going to China, and now they say he is with you. Where is he? She doesn't know. Such a nice girl, I tell you, his wife. So this fellow, ultimately, when he died, he had cancer. 15 years he had cancer. He never took any treatment. And he was going about it. Don't care at all. And he will sleep at 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock, and get up at 4 o'clock and again work. And such a fascinating man. He wrote in his paper for you. Write down. Matter is not made out of matter. It's a very good paper for lay people to read. You will understand quantum physics if you read this paper. Matter is not made out of matter. His name is Hans, H-A-N-S, Peter, P-E-T-E-R, Dürer, D-U-R-R. I quote what he wrote. I am a nuclear physicist. My job is to look at matter at a subtlest level, subtlest level, subtlest level. I have trained for my PhD with Edward Teller, the father of the hydrogen bomb. And when I found out he was doing hydrogen bomb, I left him and came back to Germany and joined Einstein and others in the Max Planck Institute. Ever since that time, that was in 1955, I have been a nuclear scientist looking at matter. And one fine day, I see there's no matter at all. Was I worried? No, I was expecting it, he says. And I call this as aduality, no duality between matter and energy. But who am I in front of the Indian sages of yore who called it as Advaita? What a beautiful thing. Who is saying that? Hans-Peter Dürer, who can't even speak English fluently, but can really speak Sanskrit. And he quotes, in the speeches he quotes, the Bhagavad Gita, from the Upanishad to Bhagavad Gita, Bahirantascha Bhutanam, it is inside and outside of everything. Charam acharamevacha, it's moving. Your energy is moving, but you look solid. It's Maya. Shankara's Maya, he calls it. He calls it as Wirklichkeit. Wirklichkeit in German means Maya, Nataka, drama. You know drama? The whole world is a drama. Now you all exist here. Do you really exist here? I don't know. If I close my eyes, you don't exist here. It is my perception that you exist here. So you are virtually, maybe here, maybe not be here, potentially here, but you exist when I see you. If I close my eyes, you don't exist. The whole world is like that. So it's a maya. Bahirantascha bhutanam charam acharamevacha sukshmavateta vijnayam. What a beautiful thought. It is so subtle that no vijnana in future also can see it. In 2017, people have not seen an electron. So many people got Nobel Prize describing an electron without seeing it. But they tell you in the physics class in BSc, if you have not seen God, God doesn't exist. Right? But you have not seen electron, electron exists because he believes in it. That's all the difference. See, so many people. One fellow, J.J. Thomson, in 1907, who was a Cavendish Institute director, said, electrons are particles. Nobel Prize. 30 years later, his own son, George Thomson, said, they are waves. Again, Nobel Prize. So everybody got Nobel Prize. Ultimately, the one boy who really did it was Werner Heisenberg. He said, uncertainty principle. You don't know what it is. You can't know where it is. What is? What is where? Where is what? And this boy says, I understood it after understanding Indian philosophy. Werner Heisenberg says, I understood my quantum physics. One of the top quantum physicists, Nobel laureate quantum physicist, says, I understood quantum physics only after understanding Indian philosophy. Can you believe that? You and I don't, because we don't believe in Indian philosophy. We don't think India exists. We think only the British gave it to us. And because even after independence for over 70 years, we had RNIs as our leaders. RNI, you know, resident non-Indians. You don't know them. You know NRIs. No, but we have most RNIs here, resident non-Indians. They are not Indians. They live here with their mind in America or England or Europe. And we had those RNIs as our chief. So they condemned India for everything. Even today there are people who condemn India. They say, what is this rubbish? But these people say, Werner Heisenberg says, I understood quantum physics. Of course, Fridtjof Capra has written a book for all of you, The Tao of Physics, where he says, I understood quantum physics when I was sleeping in the sands of, Konark, on the beach. When this hot sand, the vibration was going up, then I knew the dance of Shiva, that's the dance of the electrons. But Werner Heisenberg saying is something fantastic. And who is saying that? Again, Max Planck. Max Planck says, Indian philosophy is quantum physics. Whole quantum worldview is Indian. You can comprehend much more than what you can grasp. What is science, Western science, do you know? Fishnet hypothesis. Have you heard of fishnet hypothesis? Who has heard of fishnet? Who are BSc students here? MSc students here? Fishnet hypothesis. Sir Arthur Stanley Eddington, a Nobel laureate physicist in England. You know, madam? You know? You said you raised your hand. Dupatta? No. Ichthyologist means fish specialist, wanted to study fish. So went to the sea, caught fish, took the laboratories and used the vernier caliper, this, that, and measured the fish up and down, down below, produced evidence to say that all sea fish should be more than 2 inches in length. Why? Their net had that hole. So after 10 years, another group of ichthyologists went to the sea with a different net, with a smaller hole, that caught even half an inch fish. So they said, all sea fish is half an inch. That's another hypothesis. This is called fish net hypothesis. So Western reductionist science is so reductionist, it doesn't know what's happening on the other side of the room. And that's called fish net hypothesis. It's a very important hypothesis in science. And Arthur Stanley Eddington is a big man. He got the Nobel Prize thanks to our friend, who is that? Einstein. He was Einstein's friend. Because Einstein's theories were all proved wrong by 16 experiments. But only this fellow said, no, I'm going to repeat that experiment. And he alone did the experiment, said, Einstein is right, Newton is wrong. So Einstein said, okay, this fellow must get a Nobel Prize. So he had the, or he got. So that's the story of our friend, Stanley Arthur Eddington, who said, science is after all fish net hypothesis. So friends, in the quantum worldview, you see this whole world not as a reality, but as haps, happenings. So beautifully described by Krishna to Arjuna. When Arjuna says, who am I fighting? I don't want to fight. Who am I fighting? My own brothers, my own cousins, my own uncles, my own teacher, my own guru. How can I kill them? So he puts the Gandiva down. What does Krishna tell him? Anarya justam oparta. You are not an Arya. That means you are not authentic. You are not a good human being. You promise something to your brother that you will fight on the strength of which he came to the war. Now in the war field, you say, I am not going to fight. So you are anarya justam oparta. Akirti param. You will not get kirti. You will not. Aswargiyam. You will not ever go to swarga. So don't do that. You fail. Because you are not killing them. They are all dead. In quantum physics, they are dead. You are only a nimitta matram. I am just not joking. This is exactly what Hans Peter Due says. Haps. Haps is happenings. They just happen. Time doesn't move. You know, it's 6 o'clock, 5 o'clock, all this is our conception. That movements happen. At 5 o'clock, we were in the Ferguson Road. At 6 o'clock, I'm inside this hall. That's how time has changed. But time is the same. My grandmother's time also, the same time happened. Same thing happened. But we think time is moving. Then, of course, ordinary physicists write time and this and that, and then write books and stories, nice stories. You all read and pay money. But real thing is, time doesn't change. We change. That's called entropy. And we should stop that entropy by what's called negative entropy, by evolution. And that can be beautifully done by meditation, yoga, and pranayama. What a beautiful thought. Pranayama, movement of prana, the rife energy. And I saw a beautiful book in one of the American schools of yoga. You know, there are about 43 schools. One school I happened to go for a lecture and saw a book written by the owner of the school. And she has written Usha Yoga. Usha is her name. So Usha Yoga. all kinds of yogas are there. Here also people have their names, and then she has written prana plus yama, pranayama. So I told her, don't bring yama into this. You know, change the book. It's don't bring yama, because of course yama is all right for we doctors. You don't know that. Vaidhyarajo namastubhyam yamaraja sahodara, you are yama's brother. It's a compliment, because yama is the only god who is very ethical. He kills the dog or the king the same way, whereas all of us, you know, king the separate death and dog the different death. No, yama same. It's a compliment. But the next one is yamastu harati pranan, yama only takes life. Vaidhyo pranan danani cha, you take life and money both. It is money that has spoiled science. Up until many money came into this world, science was pure. Science had compassion. Science had some love. Science had an aim to try and understand this world. But after money came, science became money, because money spoils everything. You didn't know that. You didn't know? Before money came into the world, this world was so happy that nobody had any disease. When money came, disease came.